Hi, in this video I'll be showing you how to capture photographs of a virtual scene in Unity using the COLIBRI VR Unity package. So here we can see that we've imported a 3D mesh, which is the Suzanne monkey from Blender, and we've added a blue material so as to see some shiny highlights. So to capture this object, we're going to create an empty object, add an acquisition component. So here we see that this has created a grid of 16 cameras, and we have a preview window down here on which we can see the generated images. So let's play around with the parameters of this acquisition component. First, we have to specify an output directory in which the images will be stored. So let's start by creating a data folder next to the assets folder, and we'll put a Suzanne folder inside this data folder. And this is where we're going to store our images. So let's specify this in the acquisition component. And now we can play around with the capture. So if we launch play, we can now click on the acquire button, and this will show this pop-up, and we can click yes. And here we can see that we have our images saved in the Suzanne folder. So now if we decide to do something other than a grid, so for example a sphere facing towards the monkey, so let's place this sphere of cameras around the monkey and maybe make it a bit bigger. Okay, maybe not that big. And okay, that's pretty good. Maybe a little more cameras. So here we can modify the number of cameras on the horizontal axis and on the vertical axis. Okay, this looks reasonable. We can change the resolution here as well. Both width and height. And okay, let's try this out. So we launch play and we click on the acquisition button, and we have this nice preview of the images, and the images are stored. Okay, let's try something else. So let's go back. Let's take just one camera, but this time let's make it 360 degree. So instead of perspective, we're going to choose omnidirectional. And we can see the gizmos changed, and in the preview, you can see that this is a 360 degree image. So let's try this out. Clicking play. And clicking on the acquisition button again. And this saved our 360 degree image in the same folder. Okay, one last thing we can see is adding depth. So by clicking on this toggle, we see that we're now capturing the scene's depth information, and we can specify a minimum range and a maximum range. And this is just a visualization of the depth on the preview here. So it's the plasma color map, but it's going to store some precise depth information. So once again, we click play and we click the acquire button. And so here again, we can see that the images are stored in the images folder. And if you go in the stereo depth maps folder, we have this precise depth information.